Hi guys, and welcome to another video. So today I'm going to show you what's it like to travel to Tirana, Albania from Podgorica, Montenegro by a bus. So I'm gonna be going on the 9 a.m. bus. It's gonna take around 3 hours, but I am a bit nervous about the border crossing. So I have my passport, I have my EU ID, and I have a letter signed from my mom that I can go, because I'm 17 years old and I have to have that kind of a document with me. So hopefully it goes well and I'm not stranded at a border.
So I have stopped at a local cafe here in Podgorica to get some cappuccino and then head to the bus station.
I'm now heading back to the bus station and I bought some breakfast. So this is some sort of a cake with some jam. It was only 50 cents, so hopefully it's gonna be good, but it looks very, very delicious. So after 4.5 hours of painful bus ride that was supposed to be only 3, I'm finally in Tirana, and let me just tell you, the bus experience was just horrible. The bus driver took a break for some reason, nobody even asked for it, it wasn't supposed to be, and it was just horrible. Definitely, if you're planning to go from Podgorica to Tirana, count like it's gonna be 5 hours. There is also a traffic jam and you have to wait at a border crossing. So it is quite a bad experience, but hopefully I'll enjoy the 4.5 hours I have here in Tirana and then head back to Podgorica. But there's quite a big chance that the bus is gonna be late again, and in that case I would miss my connecting train, which would be just utterly horrible because the next train goes in a very early morning. So what you can see behind me now is the famous statue that is located on the main square here in Tirana. So the city is actually very beautiful. I really like it. When I got from the bus station, everything is just amazing. The bus ride was rubbish, but I'm hopefully gonna make the best out of the next 3 hours I have here. Okay, so I'm now going to the best rated restaurant here in Tirana. It's called the Mulishu or something like that. I don't know how to pronounce it correctly since I'm not Albanian. Hopefully it's gonna be good. So the meal that I had was called a trahana. It was just simply incredible. The food was so tasty and it was only 6 euros and 50 cents at this very fancy restaurant here in Tirana. And it was just a very good experience after the bad experience with the bus. I'm very happy now, and I'm now walking through the Grand Park here, and I'm gonna walk to the city center and head to the clock tower and explore some of the more attractions here. This is an area called Taiwan Park, and it is this park in the city center. There is even a sort of Taiwan pool, which is like a fountain, and there is a Taiwan center as well as a beautiful cafe. And yeah, I just really love the city. It's so amazing. It has this sort of different feeling than other cities. It's like modern but also historic, so it is definitely an incredible city that you need to visit.
See you up here.
So what you can see behind me is the main mosque here in Tirana, and they actually let me in as a non-Muslim, so it was very interesting. This was only the second mosque I have ever been in my entire life after the Al-Hassan Mosque in Morocco. It was just an incredible experience going to a mosque like this. I am now at the top of the clock tower, and you can see the main square and the mosque just behind me. It is just incredible. The ticket was only 2 euros to get up on this tower. I'm now heading back to the bus station. It's gonna be about 35-minute walk, and yeah, hopefully the bus will leave on time and arrive on time.
So thankfully I have made it to the train. The train is late as well, so now we are just waiting here in Podgorica. And so the bus driver that drove us here from Tirana was just horrible. I mean, the bus was late and he knew it, and even though he took a break for no apparent reason to get some coffee and just to have smoke or something. So we waited there for 15 minutes, then the border crossing was quite long, and then when we came to Podgorica, instead of going to the bus station straight away, he went to a gas station to clean the windshield of the bus. Yeah, that's just so horrible. How can someone, knowing that they have a 45-minute delay, do this kind of a thing? And like, when I told him that like I need to catch the train, he was arrogant. He said like, there are no trains in Podgorica, there are only buses, and then he left. So I think that's just something so bad, and I told him after that like, there are trains and I need to catch this one that leaves in 1 minute, and he was like okay, and yeah, so he backed down. But yeah, we still arrived 45 minutes late. And remember, when I came to Tirana from Podgorica today, we had a 1 hour and 30 minute delay. So just, you know, to give you guys a context, if you are gonna ever travel on the Drita Travel, which is the Albanian bus company, expect a service like this, a service that is not high quality. The buses are very bad. Like when I was in Morocco this March, the buses were much better, and Morocco is a bit different, is a bit of a different country than Montenegro and Albania. These are like richer countries, but the infrastructure is on such a bad level that you basically cannot expect to be anywhere on time. And yeah, so that about wraps it up for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next one.